Good night, bud. Yeah.
You're not going to eat any of my candy, are you?
No, I'm not.
Dad?
Yeah.
You're not crossing your fingers, are you?
No, I'm not. Sweet dreams.
Sweet dreams to you, too.
Hey everyone, I hope you're doing well. Just give me a second. Okay, I think we're good. I think the coast is clear. If you are worried or concerned at all about the fact that I'm about to eat our kids Halloween candy, which I don't think you are, but if you are, don't be. Between these two little buckets, there is, as you'll see in this video, I actually weighed the candy, and there's about 7.5 pounds of candy. Between these two containers. So, I think it's been about 2 years, maybe three, since I last did a Halloween candy eating video. I mean, it's not really Halloween candy, you know, per se. It's candy you can get any day of the week. Usually human beings don't hoard candy like this in one single night than they would any other day of the year. So let me tell you something. This is really the only reason to have kids, right? You know, forget all that stuff about, you know, being a father and raising a child, bringing a child up right, and blah, 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 blah. Nah. It's so that you can have a little kid to go out every Halloween and get as much candy as they can so you can enjoy it again. You get to vicariously live through your child and get to be a kid all over again for about 11, 12, 13 years before they grow up. So I can't eat like I used to, especially when it comes to sugar, and it is late at night. So I'm gonna have about, oh, I forgot to start tapping on this from the onset of this video. I do apologize. I'm probably gonna have about 3 or 4 mini size, maybe I'll snap off, you know, one bar of a Kit Kat, have one Reese cup, you know, and one small Twix. So I'm not sure how long this video will be. But I thought what we'd do is go through different types of candy. And, you know, see what ones that you might like. Maybe the ones I like. And that's really about it. Nothing too fancy or special. And let me tell you another thing. You know, all that talk I do about, you know, we belong in nature and all that. The only thing that's keeping me from going out and living a primal life like that, aside from the wife and kid, is this right here. Alright? Until this stuff goes away, I ain't never leaving civilization. Alright? I mean, let's just be frank about it. Now, I'll put up with government, and I'll put up with corruption, and all the ugly stuff that goes on. But this right here is probably the human being's only saving grace. Besides art and music. Yeah. And video games. You know what? Maybe if we can get candy, video games, music, and movies out into the forests, and some decent shelter, and some hot water, and a hot shower, and a refrigerator, and an oven, it might not be that bad living out there. Okay, but enough of all that talk. In all seriousness, this is going to last us like a year. Honestly, our son, he'll have a candy bar maybe a couple days every day, and, you know, take a break and things like that. Very moderate. We really make sure, especially knowing how I grew up. I grew up drinking soda, iced tea, chocolate milk, cereal. You know, I would eat like, I don't know how many candy bars at night after trick-or-treat. I had cavities in all of my molars by the time I was like 6 or 7. And our son, who is almost a teen, has had no cavities yet. And that is not a lie. So, yeah, I was raised on sugar. I'm surprised I did not have diabetes by the time I was like 20 or 30 years old. Really, I mean, sugar. Alright, that's enough of that. So, let's see what we got. Kit Kat. You like Kit Kat? Oh, I love Kit Kat. Just that perfect combination of like, those wafers and, the chocolate, you know? It's definitely one of the more unique types of candy bars, you know? I think there's not too many like that. What we have next? Snickers. Peanuts, caramel, nougat, and chocolate. Snickers are okay. It's too sweet for me. I mean, I like the peanut. The peanut's a good offset. You know, that's salty. But they've always seemed a little bit too sweet. I think it's the nougat and the caramel and the chocolate. You know? Still a favorite of mine. What about you? I'd love to hear from you, as always. Twix. I think this is I think we'll start with a Twix. Yeah. I'm a huge fan of caramel. I love the little, caramel squares. I think they're by Kraft. I love those little round caramels with that white cream in the middle. Yeah, I mean, caramel and ice cream. Like, I can give up, I gave up, you know, almost sober for a year, coming up November, 2018 here. I gave up smoking, tobacco in 2005, gave up smoking cannabis at that time too, hardly drink coffee, I haven't played video games for like 2 months now, well, except for, the beta of Fallout 76, so that habit. Kick back up. But sugar, and sugar is my drug, let me tell you. So let's get this open here. careful because some of these wrappers make such harsh, crinkly sounds. And it's a nightmare to work with. Okay. All right. From me to you, happy belated Halloween. Bon appetit. Twix is good. Twix is almost like a Kit Kat. Real close. You know, they have that crunchy wafer cookie thing going on. But the Twix has that caramel that the Kit Kat doesn't. Alright, let's see what else we have. This is the reigning champion of all candy, the Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. And if you don't think so, fight me. Peanut butter and chocolate are just the greatest combination. Now, sometimes I think, how many wars or, you know, could have been evaded if only people just had some chocolate instead, you know? Or had access to video games. Just think about any of the greatest wars and just think, if only those people that caused those wars, those tragedies, played a video game, you know, had access to video games. Anyway, or had a Reese's, you know? Yeah. We're gonna save this for the very end, right? Save the best for last. Let's see what else we have. I don't like M&M's that much. Too sweet. I'm not a big candy, hard candy type of person. I like chocolate, I like caramel. I do like Twizzlers. Sometimes I like Lemonheads. Sometimes I like the root beer barrels and butterscotch, but not that often. Well, first off, I don't have patience to sit here and just, you know, let a hard candy dissolve in my mouth. Ain't got time for that. So, do you like M&M's? I know a lot, you know, very popular, of course. Just not a big fan of them. Peanut M&M's. Now, I like these better. You know, because of the peanut. It kind of helps break up the sweetness. Plus, it's that salty and sweet combination. So, now let's have a peanut M&M. So, did you go trick-or-treating? Or are you too old? Or do you have kids? That went. not bad. There's not much to it. Just a plain peanut and some candy coating. Not my favorite, but it's good when they're laying around. When I was a kid, I used to go to the store all the time, the local store, whatever convenience store. And, you know, but I don't do that anymore. Yeah, I rarely buy candy bars anymore. All right, let's see what we have next. Skittles. I like Skittles once in a while. It's that kind of rare occasion. No, it's that sweet, fruity kind of light flavor, taste that I like about them. A little bit tart, too, I think, right? There's a little bit of tartness to them. Skittles, not bad. I mean, you know, I've been enjoying these ever since they came out. But like I said, I'm not a big fan of candy like this too much. Chocolate will always be my favorite. Oh, here we go. Needs no introduction. Sweetest fish. Yeah, we're gonna have to bust this open. I love sweetest fish. Now, I don't mind that these are sweet as they are. It's kind of funny. I don't like M&M's too much. I don't know why. But sweetest fish, you know, I mean, they kind of have that really sweet taste, you know, where you can have a couple and you just feel like, oh, I can't, you know, eat any more. But yet I can go through a whole bag of sweetest fish. It's a cherry flavor, right? I mean, it's artificial flavor in here. Does it say? No, it doesn't say. I think it's cherry, though. Or is it strawberry? I'm not sure exactly. Let's find out. I don't think I've ever paid much attention to what they taste like exactly. About them is how they stick to your teeth. Is that cherry or strawberry? I think I like to say strawberry, but someone would have to confirm. Okay. Twizzlers. At some of the office jobs that I've had, I would sit at a desk. And the worst thing about working at an office, aside from the fact that you're just sitting all day, no, except when you force yourself to get up and walk around or go take a break, staring at a screen, you get bored. And the worst thing to do is to bring in any kind of junk food, because you just sit there and you just eat it in one day. And I used to get those big packs of Twizzlers. I don't know how many of them that you get, like 24 or 36 or something like that. And I would just go through half of that in like 10 minutes. And then finish the bag either that same day or the next day. But yeah, I like Twizzlers. These are the pull and peel. I don't like these too much. These aren't the same as the regular Twizzlers, these pull and peel ones. They taste different. I think they might taste different intentionally. I don't know, but they don't have the same texture as the traditional Twizzlers. See what we have next. Starburst. I'm not a big fan of these kind of tart or sour candies. I mean, they're not sour, but they're very tart. That's not my thing. Starburst, Jolly Ranchers, I never really care for those. Once in a while, you know, kind of like with the Skittles, if I'm in the mood for that fruity, light kind of candy where I don't want that heavy chocolate, you know, I just want something that's kind of, you know, like fruity and light, like I already said, I'll have a Starburst. I won't go out and buy them, you know, but if they're laying around, you know, like this, and we're all out of chocolate, I'll spring for a Starburst. What about you? Do you like Starburst? I'm a goat. I will eat almost anything. I'll have mayonnaise as long as it's in potato salad and coleslaw and you can't taste it. And I can do mayonnaise when it's like on a Whopper, because when the mayonnaise is warm, it changes its texture. And you can't smell it, and it doesn't taste like mayonnaise right out of the jar. There's not too much that I won't eat. Tuna fish, not a fan of that. I haven't had everything, mind you, that exists, but I have had a lot of stuff. Okay, oh, here we go. Payday. I love this. A lot of peanuts, caramel, and I think there's like a nougat, right? I think I'll have a bite of this. Yeah. I love Payday. What about you? Now, I don't know if you've ever been trick-or-treating. You know, it all depends on where you grew up, where you lived. But we used to, when I got to a certain age, or maybe it was always, I don't know, get our pillowcases. And back in the 70s and early 80s, as kids, we could go blocks at a certain age without needing our parents to escort us or to drive us everywhere. All right. There's the Payday. It's got caramel. It's all caramel. I think there's like a nougat in there. Let me see. Maybe it is all caramel. Kind of looks like it. It looks like a caramel nougat kind of thing going on. All right. Let's have a bite of that. I love water. I mean, I love iced tea, and I love lemonade, and I like milk, and I like chocolate milk, but sometimes nothing beats water. I like a nice, cool glass of water more often, especially with lemon in it. Okay, so yeah, I love the payday because it's not too sweet. You got plenty of the salted peanuts. Then you have that caramel. That's not as sweet as, you know, regular caramel might be. Yeah, it's delicious. Love it. Alright, what else we have? Oh, here we go. Butterfinger. I've always loved these. The one thing I don't like about these too much is how they stick all up in your teeth. It's been a while since I had one. There's not too many in here, so I'm gonna skip this one. But yeah, what about you? Do you like Butterfinger? These are good. Crispity, crunchity peanut butter. So it has that chocolate coating, and then it has that crunchy, weird peanut butter type center. It almost is like a Chicka Stick. A Chicka Stick is the same as a Butterfinger. I don't know, do they still sell Chicka Sticks? I think they're the same thing. It's that weird, crunchy, almost candy-like peanut butter layered type center. But Chicka Stick doesn't have the chocolate on the outside. Yeah, so just put that aside. Here's one that I don't like too much. Maybe you do. Three Musketeer. Never care for too much nougat. It's like a Snickers bar, but without the peanuts and caramel. I don't think this has caramel, does it? Yeah, so not my favorite. If you like it, that's cool. Giant Twix bar. Snickers. Oh, here we go. Another one. Milky Way, again, not one of my favorites. Too much like the Three Musketeers. Same concept, pretty much. Although I think this has caramel, and Three Musketeers doesn't, right? I don't know. When it comes to Milky Way, Three Musketeers, and Snickers, I'll take the Snickers. I never really liked Milky Way or Three Musketeers. Have I told you that I don't like Three Musketeers or Milky Way? I just want to make sure I'm getting that point across. But what about you? Do you like them? This is how I want my last meal to be. You know? Just after I say my final words, just get like a hose and just pour chocolate, you know, down my throat, and that's it. Just want to go out just having the final taste of chocolate. Twizzlers. Are these the original Twizzlers? These might be the original Twizzlers. Twizzler twists. Just a ton of Reese's cups. It's crazy. Dig through here, see what we have. Oh, here we go. One of my favorites. If I can fish it out. I forgot all about this. This right here takes the cake. Forget the Reese cup. For everything I said about the Reese cup being the supreme, the reigning champion, Almond Joys. I love coconut. Coconut and the almond and the chocolate coating. This is the best right here. No, really, it's a toss up between the Almond Joy and the Reese's cups. I'd have to say it's a, you know, it's a tie. I think we're going to eat this, and then we'll eat the Reese's cup, and that's it. That'll do it. I'll eat this. We'll dig through here a little bit more. Let's see if there's anything else I find. Opened up here. Just open this up, just in case you've never seen the inside. Hard to see the almond, but the almond is right there. It's kind of got chocolate over it, so you really can't see it too much, and all that delicious coconut. have to watch my sugar. As you get older, it's just how it goes. And I know there's gonna come a day when I probably can't even eat this stuff. Or maybe have one, like once a week or a month. One of my grandparents had diabetes in their old age. So I'm sure it's bound to happen to me too. I'm trying my best, kinda, to watch my sugar. But like I said, sugar is my drug. It is just impossible for me to kick that habit. And all these companies know that. Anyway, gold bears. Why aren't they called gummy bears? Is gummy bears like a knockoff name or something by another company? All right, anyway, gold bears. Not a big fan. Once in a while, when it comes to, I want to have that fruity type of candy. It's light, it's not as heavy as chocolate. And only if they're laying around. All right, let's see if I can dig through here and find anything that I might have missed. So let me just tell you something right here. You see this right here? These full-size candy bars? These are your Halloween heroes right here. The people that hand out full-size candy bars. They deserve medals. Alright, that's pretty much it. Yeah, this is mostly Snickers, Reese's, a lot of the chocolate stuff, Twix. Same thing here. Twizzlers, Skittles, Hershey bar. Oh, there is one. Nestle Crunch. This is the Crisp Rice Center. I've always liked these. Not so much because these are really kind of sweet. I mean, of course, all these are sweet, but when I say, you know, something is sweet, usually what I mean is like that you can just feel the sweet just get to you. You know, I don't know how else to explain it. But what about you? Do you like a Nestle Crunch? I was just thinking, you know what? Almond Joy is like Gojira. Reese's Cups, it's like Metallica. Snickers, it's like Slayer. Skittles, it's like Bon Jovi. Gummy bears, it's like Striper. Peanut M&Ms, maybe that's Anthrax. Nestle Crunch. King Diamond? Nah, King Diamond's really kind of out there. I'm not really sure what kind of candy would represent King Diamond. That's a tough one. Yeah. Well, I'll have to rethink my candied heavy metal associations. Okay. All right, well, I'm gonna have a, finish this video here with a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup. Beautiful, isn't it? Let's just pause here a moment to really marvel at this magnificent creation. Throughout the centuries, mankind has done a lot of beautiful things. A lot of horrible things too, but we won't discuss those. They sent a monkey to the moon. They sent a couple monkeys to the moon, actually. They've, what else have they done? Created video games, movies, art. So much wonderful things that humans have done. Not bad. Stuff that's medicine. Stuff that's okay, you know? But then you have this, right here. Single most greatest invention that human beings have ever invented. It's beautiful. I don't even want to eat it. I just want to sit here and just stare at it for an hour. But I think all those people that have died for our freedom wouldn't want me to just sit and stare at it. They'd want me to eat it. That's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to do my ancestors proud. Listen to that. Even the wrapper is a thing of beauty. Have you ever heard the sound of someone tapping on a Reese's peanut butter cup before? I bet you haven't. That really wasn't worth it. Okay. Let us remove this perfect organism from its cage. Set it free. Just open that up so you can see its insides. Look at that. That's what it's all about right here. I hate to do this, but I'm going to have to flip-flop my decision again. There is no tie for reigning champion. There can be only one. Almond Joy takes second place, silver medal, but the gold medal belongs to the Reese Cup, without a doubt. Going to do it for this year. I hope this makes up for previous years that I haven't done this. Maybe this brings back a little nostalgia for you. If you used to trick-or-treat and you no longer do. Or if you've never, you know, trick-or-treated, still hopefully, maybe, enjoy some of the candy here. Alright, I gotta figure a way to put some of these back and make it look like I didn't touch this, so son doesn't get upset. So I'm going to do that. And I wish you all my best. Thanks for tuning in. See you in another video real soon. Take care. Put these back here. I don't think he's going to know that I had just a few. Like he didn't even touch it. I'm gonna have to hide the evidence though.